Good morning, children. Hope you are all fine and safe. So far, you have learned the first two lessons, which belongs to physical science. Now, we move on to the lesson unit 4, which is biology. What do you mean? The living world of plants. Biology. What do you mean by biology? That is the natural science. It is the natural science, which deals with life and living organisms and their structure and function. In biology, there are two branches, that is botany and zoology. Botany means the study about plants. Zoology means the study about animals. So, in biology, we are seeing about the botany and zoology. These are the two branches. The living world comprises of plants and animals. The plants are considered to be the living organism. Why it is considered to be the living organism? Because the plants, they breathe and they grow in size. From the seed, the plants are grow in their size. And then they reproduce. They prepare their own food. So, as the plants are doing the same as living organism, they are considered to be like living organism. The plants are considered to be the living one. Okay. Next, the plants are, they are all the parts of the plants are used as food, medicine, and some other purpose, wood, shelter. We are using all these from the plants. Next about the plant form and function. Okay, by keeping all these introduction, let us move on to the parts of the plant. The parts of the plant form and their function. When we take about the plant, all the plant comprises of the root system, which is found underground the soil, and then the portion above this is the shoot system. The shoot system comprises root system and then the shoot system. The root system is found, which is below the soil, found below the soil. And then when we take about the shoot system, it is found above the soil. Shoot system is found above the soil. The shoot system comprises of the leaf, the flower, the fruit, etc. Okay, so mainly the plant consists of two parts, the root system and the shoot system. Root system is found below the soil, and root system is found below the soil, and the shoot system, which is found above the soil. Okay, next we shall move on to the root system. The root system is found below the soil. The portion which is found under the soil, and then the portion which is found below the soil, then it comprises of the two portion, that is the main tap root system, the root system which is found below the soil. What the main function is they are fixing the plant firmly in the soil. And then when we do take about the root system, it consists of the tuft of hair like portion, that is root hairs. The root system consists of the root hairs which is found at the tip of the root, and then each tip is protected by a cap like structure that is called as root cap. What is the main function for used for protection? The root cap is used for giving protection for the roots. So root system, the root consists of the tuft of hairs which also used to fixes the plant, and then the root cap which is used for giving protection. And then the root is always known as positively geotropic. What is mean by positively geotropic? The root always moving towards the earth. The geo means moving towards earth. Tropics mean movement. As the root grows towards the earth, they are known as positively geotropics. So when we take about the root are found underground the soil, and then they contains the root hairs and then root cap which is protective in function, and then the root is known as positively geotropics. So this is about the structure of the root system. And then we move on to the types of the roots. There are two types of root system: tap root system and fibrous root system. System. When we take about tap root system, which is the characteristics of dicotyledons. Di means two, cotyledon mean leaves, as two leaves, and then the seed can be in two forms, as it contains two leaves in their embryo, they are known as dicotyledon, which is the characteristics of taproot system. The taproot system consists of the single root which move deep into the soil, and then it consists of the lateral branches. The lateral branches, which is known as the primary root system. The lateral branch, which is known as the primary root system. The primary root, that is also known as the tap root, which is again divided into secondary root. It consists of the main axis, single axis, which is again divided into the secondary root. The secondary root in turn is divided into tertiary root. So when we take about the tap root, it is only a single root which is again divided in, which contains the lateral root. The lateral root again divided into secondary and tertiary. The main single root is also known as the primary root. This type of root system we can find in beans, mango. In these plants we can find this type of tap root system. Okay, next about fibrous root system. When we take about the fibrous root system, it contains the tuft of root hairs which is found below the surface of the soil. There is no such difference like lateral root, primary, secondary roots are not found in these fibrous root system. It consists only the tuft of root which is found below the surface of the soil. See, this is known as the tap root system. There is a primary root and then the secondary root, tertiary root which arises. This is the tap root system. When we take about the fibrous root system, it contains only the tuft of root hairs, tuft of root which arises below the surface of the soil. They are all thin and uniform in size. Thin and uniform. Example, grass, paddy. In all these plants, we can find this fibrous root system. So, when we take about the root system, there are two types of root, the tap root and the fibrous root system. The tap root contains the single root which arises below the surface of the soil, and it also contains the lateral roots, primary, secondary and tertiary root. Then it is an example of, it belongs to dicotyledon plant. It contains two cotyledon. If we take the bean seed, we can split into two. So that belongs to dicotyledonous plants. When we take next about the fibrous root system, this fibrous root system is in, we can find in grass and paddy. If we take the paddy seed, we cannot split into two. So that is known as the monocotyl seed. Monocotyledon. Monocotyledonous seed. So it contains the tuft of hairs, a group of root hairs which arises from the, which arises below the surface of the soil. So these are the two types of roots which is found in plants. And then this can be explained through an example. For this, what we have to do means, before that I want to explain that some of the modification which is found in plants. As I said earlier, the plants can prepare their own food, isn't it? They are storing their extra food either in the root or in the stem or in the leaves. The plants are storing their extra food in their root or in their stem or in their leaves. Such a kind of modification is found in the plants. For example, if we take carrot, it is a kind of the root which is stored in underground. And then beetroot, radish, these are all the modification of root. When we take about ginger, sugarcane, these are all the modification of stem. And then leaves, the leaves, all the greens, and then the cabbage, these are all the leaf modification. Flower modification is cauliflower. So what the plant are doing, they are preparing their own food. After preparation, the extra food is there. What is the food prepared by the plant are known as starch. The starch are the carbohydrate. This is the food stored, this is the food prepared by the plant during photosynthesis. So what they are doing after preparing their food, they are storing their extra food either in their root or in their stem or leaves or in the flower. This is known as the modification. So when we take about the root, there are some functions are there. functions of the root. Each and every part of the plant is doing some function. The function of the root, main function is anchorage or fixation. The main function for the plant is fixing the plant firmly in the soil. So this is one of the important function. Anchorage means fixing the plant firmly in the soil. And the next one is the conduction. What we are doing, we are pouring water into the soil. That water is taken up by the root and then they are passing the water to other parts of the plant. So that is known as conduction, passing the water to all the parts of the plant. That is conduction. Next one, storage. As I said, in carrot, beetroot, modification, in carrot, beetroot, radish, they are storing their extra food. So these are all the sum of the functions of the food, that is anchorage or the fixation, conduction. They are storing their extra food, that is known as modification. And then absorption, conduction, absorption. After we are pouring the water, it is absorbed by the root hairs which is present in them, and then it is conducted and then passed to all parts of the body. These are all the main functions of the plant. So this can be explained by an experiment. Conduction of water is proved by an experiment. For that, what we need is we have to take one carrot, vegetable, the carrot, and then we should take a beaker, fill the beaker with blue ink, keep the carrot inside the beaker and keep it for 2 days. After 2 days, we may observe a streak of blue color portion is seen in the carrot plant. Okay, why? Because as the carrot belong to the modification of root, what does it do? It absorbs the water which is blue in color. Okay, that blue color is found in the carrot plant. Okay, so from this we can observe the plant are conducting the water. So they are absorbing the water which is present in the soil, and also the minerals are found in the soil. So all these are absorbed and then conducted by the root system. Then it is passed on to all parts of the plant. So conduction is proved by doing this experiment. So for this we have to take one carrot, and then take a beaker, fill it with water, and then pour two drops of ink, either blue ink or red ink. We should keep the carrot inside the beaker. After that, after 2 or 3 days, we can find a streak of blue ink which is found in the inside the carrot plant. Carrot. So from this we are observing that the plants are conducting. They are absorbing, they are conducting, storing their extra food, and then they are fixing the plant firmly in the soil. So this is about the root system of the plant. Ginger is given. So ginger is the part of the stem modification. Ginger is the part of stem modification. As the plant are storing their extra food, they are preparing their food, and then they are storing the food in the stem. That is, example is the example for this is the ginger. So ginger is, it is not a root, it is the stem portion. So this root system is root system. When we come, so far what we have learned means we have learned about biology, which comprises the two parts, botany and zoology. We are dealing with the study of plants. Okay, and then the plant contains the parts of the plants are the leaves, the stem, the root, the flower and the fruit. And then there are many forms and colors of the structure, but even though they are coming under a single category, that is we can find all the root below the soil and the shoot system above the soil. Okay, then we come across the two system, taproot system and fibrous root system. Taproot system, which is the characteristics of the dicotyledons, and then fibrous root system, which is the characteristics of monocotyledons. And then about their function, they are conducting, fixing the plant firmly in the soil, storage, and then they are modification, they are storing some food in their root system. So these are all the functions of the root. Then we move on to the shoot system. We move on to the shoot system. The aerial part of the plant. Aerial means the portion which is seen above the ground. That is known as the aerial portion. The aerial part of the plant which is found above the soil or above the ground is known as the shoot system. The shoot system comprises of the leaf, the flower, and the fruit, as I said already, isn't it? So the aerial part of the plant, which is called as shoot system, the shoot system comprises of the stem. Stem is the main portion of the shoot system. As I said, in root, they are positively geotropic, isn't it? They are growing towards the earth. The shoot system is known as positively phototropic. Because the plants, the stem portion is moving towards the sun. So as they are moving towards the sun, photo means the sunlight. Tropic means movement. As the stem move towards the sunlight, the stem is also known as positively phototropic, but the root is known as positively geotropic. Stem is known as positively phototropics. When we take about the shoot system, it contains the leaf and then flower, fruit, etc. The portion in which the leaf arises, the part of the plant from which the leaf arises, the portion where the leaf arises from the stem is known as node. The portion where the stem, where the leaf arises from the stem is known as the node. And then the successive interval between, so the portion in from which the leaf arises from the stem is known as the node. And then the successive interval between one node and the another node is known as internode. Okay, the portion where the leaf arises from the stem is known as node, and the successive interval between the two node is known as internode. So the shoot system comprises of the node and the internode. Node mean the place where the leaf arises, and then internode mean that the interval between the two node is known as internode. And then the flower, about the flower. Some flowers arises at the tip of the stem, that is known as terminal flower. We can find the flower at the tip of the plant in some plants. So that is known as terminal flower. If the plant, if the leaf, fruit, if the flower arises at the tip of the plant, it is known as the terminal flower or the terminal bud. And then, while if it arises at the side, laterally, lateral, if the flower arises at the lateral side of the plant, it is known as axillary bud. Okay, if the flower arises from the tip of the plant, it is known as terminal bud. If the flower arises at the side or the axil mean the place where the leaf is there, or leaf, flower, fruit, everything is arises, that is known as axillary bud. If it arises lateral side, it is known as axillary bud. Then, so this is about the structure of the shoot system. The remaining portion we shall see in the next class.